Hey guys, welcome back to Mobizium. Today we're talking about something which is a pretty big trend right now in flagship smartphones. We're talking about dual cameras. Pretty much the next big thing with smartphone cameras. These days you find a lot of the top of the line phones like the LG G6 V30, the new Galaxy Note, the new iPhone X, the new OnePlus. All these phones have two lenses at the back of the phone instead of just one. And these add a host of new features like bokeh mode or even optical zoom, and it's extremely helpful. But we want to help you understand what dual camera does and how it can help you. If we're talking about bokeh mode, it's essentially like when lighting blurs up in an image, that's what you call bokeh. And bokeh mode is when your subject is sharp in focus and the background is blurred out. With dual camera phones, this usually happens with the two lenses being used to gauge the depth and figuring out how far the background is and using the software to blur that out. And most times this gives a really cool effect, but it can also go wrong. The ideal distance to be maintained between the subject camera and the background is very important. Usually it's best to have the subject at least 2.5 meters or less away from the camera lens and the background as far as possible, because the further the background, the better the image looks and the easier it is for the software to blur it. Of course, since it is software, it gets better with time, but very often you'll find that the blur, there's a little bit of leak, sometimes hairlines get blurred, and it's not very accurate. Which is why usually when a traditional physical bokeh is usually done through a DSLR's lens, where it physically has a depth of field till the subject. So everything beyond has to get blurred because it just isn't in focus. Here it's done by software, which is why these distances put you in a pretty weird predicament. Now, if you're wondering about the lighting conditions, good lighting can make or break a photo. It's really important to have, in pretty much any image, the lighting fall directly on the subject as compared to on the camera lens. And due to the limitations of these smartphone cameras, most times low light photos will not be as great as ones with good lighting. So it is paramount to have really good lighting conditions. If we're talking about zoom, it's very important to first understand the difference between digital zoom and optical zoom. Let's for example take, if you're painting a photo, if you paint a house smaller than that or bigger, it'll be as clear. That's pretty much what optical zoom is. When there's a physical change and the lens has a different focal length, that's why it zooms in on the frame. But digital zoom is like painting a house that big and then stretching it out to make it look bigger, which is why you lose a lot of detail, and it's basically software stretch. So we would recommend you use as less of digital zoom as possible and stick to using optical zoom as and when available. In some dual camera phones like the OnePlus 5, they have a 2x optical zoom, which is where there'll be a very minimal loss in detail. Also, when zoomed in, the smallest of movements make a large impact, which is why using a tripod was really important. But as and when we move forward with technology, there's a lot more optical image stabilization in the telephoto lenses and phones as well. So the requirement for a tripod per se reduces the more we move forward, which is great. Some of the dual cameras, instead of offering an optical zoom, offer an ultra wide lens like the LG G6, the LG V30, the budget friendly Moto X3. And the advantage here is basically just you can get a lot more into the frame. So if you're taking, for example, a group photo or a panorama and you want to get more people or more objects into your frame, you very simply just switch to the ultra wide lens and you get a much larger frame to work with. The advantages of a feature like this are just limited to the user. If you're wondering about what camera to use, some phones allow you to choose between both cameras, and here we mostly recommend that sometimes in low light conditions the telephoto lens just won't work as well as the primary, so you'd be better off using the primary rear lens for photos like that. And then there are also some phones like the Honor 8 Pro which uses both cameras mandatorily at all times, in which sense one lens records monochrome data and the other records RGB data, so it puts together those to create a more detailed photo. So in phones like that you can't really choose, but where you can, we recommend you do. But that's about it for today. That's a quick lesson on dual cameras in general and how they can work for you. Thank you for watching. Make sure to subscribe to our channel. We drop cool new tech videos every single week. And this is Vedant Lamba signing off. Peace.